Good evening, tasty liquor lovers. Welcome to Swill and Grog's Beer Review number 26. And what is it that we'll be reviewing this evening, you may ask? Here it is. Whistler Premium Export Lager. 5% alcohol by volume. What more can I tell you about Whistler? Well, until the other day, I'd never laid eyes on it. It's proudly brewed in British Columbia, Canada. Much like American beers, Canadian beers are also very poorly represented in Australia, I'm afraid to say. So, this is something I was very surprised to find when I went beer shopping. So I thought I'd have to try it out, even though it does come in this 330ml clear bottle, which is not a good thing, as you know. Alright. I do quite like the picture there on the label. Quite nice. Well, what does it say on the back? Whistler Brewing Co. Premium Export Lager. Naturally brewed and carefully aged without preservatives or additives. A pure and truly refreshing lager. Brewed exclusively with Whistler Glacier Water. Alright. Well, I think without further ado, we're going to have to give Whistler here a try. Alright. So let's open it up. I think it's a while since it's... I had the Helena last, and that wasn't a twist top. I've had an awful lot of twist tops of late, so it would seem. Anyhow, here's our nice ice-cold glass. So let's give this a good pour, a nice aggressive pour. Apparent that there's a lot of carbonation. Look at that that foamy head there. Let's just give it a moment to settle. What more can I say? It's my 26th beer review. Now, if this were a TV show, it would be traditionally the end of season one. Unfortunately, I can't think of anything interesting or riveting to do in this last beer review for the season. It would actually be the first Canadian beer that I've reviewed in all these reviews that I've done, but not surprising, because as I said, Canadian beers are very poorly represented here. Probably more so than American beers, in fact. Which is a shame, because I do recall having a lot of Canadian beers over the years, but they were only available for what seemed like a limited amount of time before they vanished forever. Beers like Labatt Blue and Molson Ice, Moosehead may have been another one. It was an awful long time ago I had these, Anyhow, this Whistler is certainly retaining that head there. Maybe I gave it too aggressive a pour. But anyway, let's just pour out some more. Okay. Now, let's have a look at the beer itself, the appearance. It's a very clear golden colour, which is quite pleasing to the eye. Looks very good from this angle. And it's a nice foamy head there too, which is nice to see. Anyhow, let's have a smell. It's, It's a surprisingly pleasant aroma. I was anticipating that this beer would be skunked, being that it's in a clear bottle, but very sweet, malty aroma there. Probably a little bit of a little bit of sourness I'm smelling in it, but a sweet, pleasant aroma. I guess it's just you can smell a bit of malt and a bit of hops there. But very pleasant. I'm quite surprised at that. Anyhow, let's have a taste. I taste a very sweet caramelly flavour there. I'm still tasting it actually. It's quite malty as well. The first thing I really noticed is that real sweet caramelly flavour. Which is complemented nicely by a rich malty flavour. But I think it's got a little bit too much in the way of hop bitterness. As I'm yakking on here about the flavour, I'm really tasting a very sour, bitter aftertaste now, which is not very pleasant at all, I must say. But on that note, I'll drink some more. I'm hoping I get another hit of that sweet caramel. Now that is very pleasant, I must say, but I have to say it is spoiled. It's spoiled by, too much in the way of hop bitterness. It doesn't balance out very well. And the aftertaste is becoming more unpleasant for me, I'm afraid to say. There's a little bit of lacing. It's not too bad as far as head retention goes. There's still a bit of head there. Not what I was expecting, actually, but anyhow, I'm going to drink a bit more. I might as well finish this. Sweet caramelly taste, that rich maltiness is really getting more and more overpowered by this hot bitterness. I'm not really enjoying the aftertaste. It's very unpleasant. Yeah, it really does spoil it. But anyway, I'll just finish the remainder. Well, there we go. It's not too bad. It's far from ordinary, but definitely not extraordinary. I'm not sure whether I'd really go out of my way to have it again. I could think of a lot better beers that are out there. I'm afraid to say, I'm somewhat disappointed with this. Yeah, there's much better beers out there, let's face it. Alright, so... Oh, I didn't actually mention what I thought of it in terms of its drinkability, did I? Stupid me. Well, in terms of drinkability, I'd kind of tire of it due to that, overpowering hot bitterness. After one or two of these, be looking for something else in the fridge. Yeah, so it doesn't rate very highly in terms of drinkability. The one thing that really does impress me, though, is that, that sweet caramelly taste that you, got initially, from that first sip. Anyhow, in terms of a rating out of 10, it's not terrible. I certainly wouldn't go out of my way to buy it again. It's better than a light beer. I would probably give it 6.5 out of 10. Yeah, I'm happy with that. 6.5 out of 10. I think that's only fair. Anyway, that brings us to the end of yet another Swill and Grog beer review. And like I said, if this were a TV show, it would in fact be the end of the first season. But there's not going to be any hiatus for me. I'm going to be back very soon with yet another beer review. So yeah, that's only going to be a day or two away, I'm sure. Anyway, until next time, fare thee well, all. Fare thee well.